have a seat right here.
I'm Destiny Moon. My tonsils are like a bajillion sizes bigger than they should be. And I have a super bad gag reflex. Like I'll start coughing and stuff because I'll start gagging on something and these little white things kept coming out, like hard balls. They smell like sulfur and like just ick. So I was Googling it and found out that they were tonsil stones. The most I've ever had come out of my throat was like 15-ish. I don't know if you've ever seen the aquarium like pebble stones like in fish tanks. It was like that big. And it's awful.
Hello, how are you? Destiny, right? I am Mark, nice to meet you. So what's going on with you today?
My family doctor said that I needed to come up here because I have these really bad tonsil stones and that I needed to get them checked out.
Did they cause you any problems? Do they hurt?
I can't swallow water without choking.
Okay.
Like, bad.
All right. How long has this been going on for?
My entire life, but it started getting really, really bad when I was pregnant with my son, who's now 3.
Do they cause you any other issues like pain, bad breath, things like that at all?
Probably. Like the bad, I'm assuming. Okay. The tonsil stones smell when they come out, so I'm just
yes, unfortunately they do smell very bad.
Crypts are like holes in the tonsils. Kind of like if you think about how the moon looks, and then the holes produce keratin, and then, you know, epithelial cells, bacteria, and just debris kind of mixes together and forms those little stones, and then they stick in there until you pop them out. Tonsil stones can be anywhere from a size of a grain of sand to, I've seen some tonsil stones about the size of a pinky nail, so pretty large. All right,
you can go ahead and remove your mask if you're fine with that.
Worst case scenario is the definitive treatment is to remove the tonsils, and unfortunately that's not a pleasant procedure.
A little bit of a deviated septum,
but your nose otherwise looks great.
All right, let's see these things. Big eye, look right up here for me. So about 3+ tonsils, and definitely very cryptic. You can see the holes in the tonsils. You have a bad gag reflex?
Yes, awful.
Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray some stuff in your throat. It'll numb it up and blunt the gag reflex a little. Unfortunately, it tastes really bad.
Oh. Understatement.
Yes.
All right, let's see if we can do this. So look up here just a little bit, just like that. So you can see one right over here on the left side. Go the other side.
Oh, sorry.
Nope, you're fine, you're fine. It's normal. There's one, small one. You good? Go the other side. Take your time.
Sorry.
Go the other side.
Sorry.
All right, same thing. Turn this way just a little bit.
Oh, sorry. Told you it was really bad.
No, it's okay.
Tonsil stones have a very foul smell, similar to a dead animal, like roadkill. They're not pleasant.
Oh, goodness.
Smells bad.
So with tonsils like yours, the only good treatment is gonna be just removing your tonsils. Now, it's not a fun surgery.
Yeah.
So fair warning.
Destiny came in with tonsil stones. Unfortunately, no way to fix this problem without just taking the tonsils out at this point. Certainly should help the swallowing and the discomfort back there as you have. But the good news is you won't ever have a tonsil stone again. She'll suffer for 10 to 14 days to get it out. So when someone is willing to do that, you know it's probably significant enough. In the long run, it's usually worth it for them. No tonsils, no tonsil stones.
So in this bag, go put your shoes. And your gown goes on like this.
I'm here to get my tonsils taken out and deal with the tonsil stones that are building in the back of my throat. It's nerve-wracking, and I'm stressed out, nervous. I just want to get the surgery over with because the tonsils are awful.
Destiny.
Yes.
I love that name. It's fantastic, but I love the hair more. I'm Dr. Jeffrey Gallops. I'm the medical director of the Ear, Nose, and Throat Institute. One of the most anxious times for a patient is that morning, that day of surgery. So I always try to lighten the mood a little bit.
You have much pain from it?
Yeah, a lot of discomfort at least.
Well, that's gonna be gone. Everyone knows someone that's had a tonsillectomy, and you think, oh, it's a fairly benign procedure, but it has its own complications, so we want to be very selective about why we're doing this.
Dr. Bowman Kirk's taking care of you today. I'll be in the room, but not performing the surgery. I'm excited for
you.
Great to meet you.
The number one complication of a tonsillectomy is bleeding. One of the other complications is when you take tonsils out, sometimes it creates more swelling than the tonsils created at the time. Now, this is temporary, but if you have that, then you could suffocate.
Hello, hello, Destiny. Hi, Dr. Bowman Kirk. Nice to meet you.
This is just oxygen. We'll have you start taking those nice deep breaths in and out. Put your chin up towards the ceiling for me. Perfect. You been on any vacations lately?
No, need one.
You need one? Okay.
Well, you're gonna get one now.
Yep.
I'm starting the medication now to help you drift off to Gatlinburg. Enjoy that nap.
This is a McIver retractor. It does a really good job of keeping the mouth nice and open.
My tonsils, they've always been a problem. I'm super excited to get the surgery over with, and I'm really hoping that we can get it out today.
Look at that.
Good.
Oh, yeah. Plenty to grasp onto there.
That is right.
Tonsils can be very deceiving. So when I looked in her mouth, it was huge and inflamed. It looks like they've been bleeding. You know, they're just raw. That is a really good indicator of somebody who needs their tonsils removed.
So she has cryptic tonsils with those crypts and crevices, and they're enlarged as well.
In the tonsil itself are called crypts, and it's where food has been pushed into these little holes in the tonsils. And after a while, they become thick, kind of like sand on the beach. Then after that, they become stones. I've seen stones as this big, look like a spearhead. In fact, I still have that one in my desk drawer.
And that is it.
Fantastic.
Destiny.
Destiny, you're all done.
Going through stage two.
There you go, cough it up.
Destiny, you're just waking up, okay?
Hey, Destiny, can you open your eyes?
As you can see, she's trying to fight this a little bit. Won't open her eyes, she's not responding to them. You know, she's biting a little bit on the tube. They're trying to get this out, and she's totally unaware of any of this at this point.
Gotta relax, okay?
Perfect.
You're all finished, my dear.
Welcome back.
It's hard for me to not put myself in their position because I had my tonsils out when I was a kid and I still remember it. She's gonna wake up, she's gonna have a very sore throat, she's gonna be groggy, but after the grogginess goes away, it's gonna be the worst sore throat she's ever had. But it's gonna cure the problem.
I'm way too excited because I just want everything to be better. And I might actually be able to like eat food and enjoy food again, and that would be super great.